Welcome to Friday Night Vibes. Stick around for Lozz Benson and Drey Rollan as they bring us some country and western favourites served with a side of southern rock. Thanks for tuning in and enjoy the show.
All right, g'day everyone. My name's Lozz Benson and this is my friend Drey Rollan on guitar. And welcome to Friday Night Vibes, coming from you from Wesley. And this is brought to you by Hornsby Council. So we're really stoked to be here. This is a great opportunity for us. I've been looking forward to this all week. And we're going to play a couple of tunes for you guys. So I hope you enjoy. This first one, we're going to have a bit of a jam. It's a favorite of ours. It's called Big Boss Man. All right, Jay, take it away. That was really cool, right? I have to give a shout out to my friend Cam for buying me this great washboard, which is not just used for washing clothes on. We're going to do another tune now, one of my favourites by a well-known sort of southern rock band.
Yeah.
It's Steppenwolf Southern Rock.
Early pioneers, I guess.
Yeah. So this is a favourite of mine. It's called Born to be Wild. All right. Get your moan running, head out on the highway, looking for adventure, and whatever comes our way. Embrace, fire all of your guns and
a true nature child. We were born to be wild, and we can fly so high. I never wanna die. Born to be wild. Born to be wild. Yeah. You know. One more time.
Drey Rollan, ladies and gentlemen.
This is Lozz Benson.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, call me Benson. All right, so I am really excited to play this baby. This is my Auto Harp. I should really give her a name. I was thinking Audrey the Auto Harp and Beryl the Bass Drum. It's, I know they're pretty old school names. But we are going to honor the Auto Harp and honour a couple of songs and musicians that played the Auto Harp. And the first song that we're going to kind of pay homage to is good old Johnny Cash. So without further ado, let's give this one a crack. Okay. All right, that was fun. Alrighty. I had a lot of fun choosing this set list, actually. Another one of my shameless favorites. I really do love this song. Again, some of the pioneers of Southern rock. And I used to think this was a person, but it's actually a band. Lynyrd Skynyrd, right?
Yeah.
So we're going to play a little bit of Sweet Home Alabama for you. Ready? One, two, three, and... Big
Lindsay Young sing about her. I heard O'Neill put her down. And I hope Neil Young will remember. A southern man don't need him around. Anyhow, oh yeah. Sweet home Alabama. Where skies are so blue. Sweet home Alabama. Lord, I'm coming home to you, yeah. Yeah.
Sweet home Alabama.
Yeah.
Thanks, Drey. You know, it was good. Okay, so, wow, Creedence. What a band. I've got a Creedence Clearwater Revival CD in my car and it just stays there, which means that every time I get in the car, it's a grand old time. And I always pump up Fortunate Son, but we're going to do a little bit of Bad Moon Rising for you guys now. So let's give this one a red hot crack. Yeah. Okay. I'll start this one off.
Sure.
Yeah. All right. Take it away.
Got your things together. Hope you
All right, Bad Moon on the Rise. What's next? What have I got in there? Ah, no, I'm actually going to stay on the Auto Harp. A little quick story about the Auto Harp. So I'm actually a drummer. I studied drums, and just recently, actually, I basically got this because I wanted to play bluegrass, but I didn't want to just play snare or washboard. I felt a bit left out, and I wasn't going to start learning the bass, and I wasn't going to learn the banjo or the guitar. So this is kind of like a midway point. So really, this is just kind of a bit of fun. But we're going to play a tune now, which is not originally played on the Auto Harp. I actually watched a really great movie called, is it Crazy Heart?
Yeah.
With Jeff Bridges. And this is a really beautiful song, and I really love it. So hopefully we can do it justice. But yeah, this is called Flying and Falling by Jeff Bridges. So enjoy.
I shouldn't see, doing what I shouldn't do, and being who I shouldn't be. A voice told me it's all wrong, another voice told me it's all right. I used to think that I was strong, but lately I just lost the fight.
Fowling. I would like to say at this point, yeah, thanks again to Hornsby Council for organising this, because yeah, it's been a really good chance to catch up with you, Dre.
Yeah.
Yeah, this has been a while. Yeah, it has. It has been a while. Holy moly. So yeah, this has definitely got me feeling some good vibes. So yeah. Alright, we're going to perform a little song now. Some of you might not have heard of her, but she's a beautiful songwriter, Casey Musgraves. We're going to have a crack at a little tune of hers.
You're going to start this one, aren't you?
Yeah. What am I doing? Got my little shakers here. Actually, do you know what? Maybe, do you want to start it?
Okay.
Yeah, somewhere around there.
Alright.
One, two, three. Born in a hurry, always late. Haven't been early since '88. Yeah.
slow burn. Yeehaw!
Cool.
Yes, I've chosen a slow ballad for the people at home that are having a chill night. Maybe they're not having Friday night. They're having Friday night vibes, but they're having like a chill Friday night. They're not having like a party night. So this is for you folks out there. And we're going to pay tribute to a great songwriter called Mr. John Denver. Oh my God, I was tearing up at the end there. Yeah. Wow, it's so funny. I've sung that song so many times and sometimes it just kind of brings it on. But I guess that's what music does. It can make you feel all sorts of emotions.
It's a really beautiful song, really.
Yeah.
The great songwriter.
Yeah. Sorry, Drey, I thought I was going to start crying on you there. I was like, no, I can't. Oh, okay. All right. So, do a little Dolly Parton tune now because I can't play Auto Harp and not play Dolly Parton. It would be a sin.
Yeah.
So I had a bit of fun choosing a Dolly Parton tune, and she's written some really beautiful tunes, some really badass tunes as well. But we're just going to do a good old classic. This one is called Jolene, and I'll be playing some kick drum as well.
Cool. Are we starting this together?
Maybe I'll just do a little bit of an ad lib thing.
Cool.
Okay. Alrighty. Next, we're going to bring it back up.
Yeah.
Ooh, going to bring out the washboard again.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Which one do you want to do? Sweet?
Yeah. Let's do Sweet Home Chicago.
Okay.
I wish I had some, you know that, what's that, Herb Albert, Spanish Flea? I wish I had that playing. If I was organized, I would have done that while I'm putting my picks on to play the washboard. But let's just pretend that that's playing in the background. Alrighty. So, yeah, thank you so much for joining us, folks. I've had a great time. And this has been fun. Oh, look at me. I can't even... Look, I'm such a bit of a rookie at this. Folks, I'm a drummer. So, you know, here we go. I'm just... having a hard time putting these on my fingers. Yeah, we've had a great time. So thank you for joining us. And if you'd like to hear more or follow us or any of that mumbo jumbo stuff, you can... Well, I mean, Drey has his own stuff. You can follow Drey Rollan. You can find him on Instagram. And we've both got our respective bands. You can follow me on Instagram at Lozz Benson. Or I've got a rockabilly band called That Redhead. I've got a... kind of southern rocky band called Benson and the Outlaws, and I guess this is going to be my new format. This is actually what isolation's been really good for, so I've kind of been experimenting with these new instruments and this format, which is kind of cool. Yeah. All right, I'm going to stop talking. let's play this tune.
Blue blues?
Yeah, you want to start it off, Drey?
Hey.
Feeling good. All right, folks. Well, I think that is all we've got time for today. So thank you so much for watching and tuning in, and thank you, Drey, for doing this with me.
This is really cool.
And thank you. You guys can't see behind the scenes, but we've got a great sound and lighting crew. I think I'm going to, I've got some questions that I'm going to have a hot crack at. I've just had some people sending in some questions, so I'm just going to quickly go on the, sorry folks, I need that background music again. We just got some people asking some questions. So, I'm just going to put my washboard down. Okay, so here we go. I'll read the questions out. How about that? Someone's asked, can you tell us a little about you and your career? Drey, I guess I'll just speak about myself.
Yeah, of course.
Well, little old me. Yeah, as I said, I'm a drummer, so I'm actually missing my whole kit. I feel very naked right now. But as I've mentioned, I've just picked up the Auto Harp, which I'm loving. And yeah, I've been playing around for a long time. I've been a local forever. Love West Lee. I love living on the bush. And you lived here for actually a while.
Yeah,
actually, that's how...
Yeah, for a while, yeah.
Yeah.
A few years, yeah.
So me and Drey have had many a jam together. But yeah, I'm a performing musician and I do this as a living. So this is what I do. Yeah, so let's see. How has COVID affected our work as a musician? Well, it's...
we're not gigging.
So no, we're not gigging.
That's our biggest downfall, I'd say.
Yeah. I think for someone like me, and I think what a lot of people don't realize is, especially as a musician, you can have different forms of income. So like if we're talking like seriously, yeah. I teach, so I do teach a little bit. But in terms of the gigs, just imagine, yeah, it's literally like the rug's been pulled from underneath. So like the whole rest of the year, all the festivals that we had booked up, like Blues yeah. Fest and Splendor in the Grass, all gone. So we were twiddling our thumbs there for a second, but yeah, definitely this is actually one of the things that's been really good. So just writing more. Let's see, how have we found isolation?
I'd say a bit rewarding in a way in terms of songwriting, being creative, because you're not on that constant circle of just gigging.
Yeah. I've actually spoken to a lot of my musician friends, and although the COVID has been like really tragic and really horrible, a lot of people are saying they've actually been focusing on their well-being and their health and their songwriting and practicing. So yeah, it's riding the wave, I've been saying. It's a bit like riding the wave. You definitely have the ups and the downs. Have you discovered how to cook any new meals in ISO? I've made a couple of really good ham, cheese, tomato toasties, and I made homemade chai. Have you made anything?
Ravioli.
Ravioli? But did you make it?
No.
You cheated. Come on. yeah. oh, actually, no, sorry. I will tell a funny story. I tried to make a minestrone soup the other night, but I didn't add enough water and it turned up into a rice mush. Anyway. So have I learned to cook any new meals? I attempted to and failed. What do you think about the arts and music scenes in our local area? The arts. Well, I know that like Hornsby is pretty supportive. Like when I was a teenager, I remember Hornsby Council would put on, was it Music in the Mall? I think like, you know, where the Hornsby Mall is, where the fountain is. So like I've always known them to be pretty supportive of the arts, which is really cool. Music scene in our area in terms of venues, I'm sure there's a couple of little cafes around, but I'm not sure what venues are in Hornsby. Or maybe they've got the pubs, they've got RSL.
The RSL is pretty well known.
RSL, there you go. I think they've been pretty supportive. So, and like again, this whole initiative, it's been awesome. Yeah. So thanks guys. Good on ya. Like, it's been bloody good. I've been looking forward to this all week. So it's really definitely lifted my spirits. And music is who I am, who we are. It's a part of us. It's what we do. So yeah, thank you so much for letting us perform for you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. And I had a great time. Tune in next time. Because there'll be more, I'm sure there'll be more great acts and artists on. So have a great evening, folks, and stay positive. We'll see you soon.
See ya.